corner of 187th and Belmont Avenue. This was my neighborhood. I can still hear a million voices in my head. Hear a million stories. This is a Bronx tale, and it's my story. The world I lived in, the people I knew. It's just a Bronx tale, and like they all do, it starts right here on Belmont Avenue. My name is Colosio Lorenzo Alfredo Romano Anela. This is my building, and that's my stoop. My stoop! I grew up right over a bar called the Shade Mimi. It's where all the wise guys hung out. And on warm summer nights, all throughout the neighborhood, you'd be able to hear the sounds of young Italian men romancing their women. Neighborhood. It was like paradise to me. I can hear the church bells and smell the freshly baked bread. See the storefront awnings, the neon green, white, and red. Cannolis on tray after tray. Salamis hung up on display. Their wares door to door, while the jukebox jockeys dance in the candy store. Grandma's calling across while stirring the Sunday sauce. And in the middle was me.
Oh, oh, and the streets start sighing. Oh, oh, and the girls start buying a broom. Come on, come on.
Strut right past my stoop.
Come on, come on. Sit down in the can, watch your beach in the sand. Why the hell is not your moon?
Room 300, bring her home, you're in the crew.
A universe of one little love.
Everywhere I go. Sonny was the number one man in the neighborhood. He had five fingers, but he only used three. All day and night, he'd be right here on the corner. He'd stand there nodding his head at all the old ladies going by with their shopping, and they treated him like a god. And in my neighborhood, he was a god. I mean, I couldn't keep my eyes off him, but he never looked at me, never. Until one day, I was 9 years old.
Hey, get back here, you old lady!
Yeah, I got a problem with you!
Oh, yeah?
This is a Bronx tale, and it's my story. The one that shattered the world that I knew. Here's how it happened, and all of it's true. It starts right here on Belmont Avenue.
Hello, Drew! Oh. Are you alright? Are you alright?
I'm alright, Mommy.
Thank God.
Daddy, they were fighting over a parking space. Sonny shot him. Why? It was just a parking space. Why?
It wasn't just a parking space, son. Who knows why? Maybe they just met at the wrong point in their lives. Come on, let's get upstairs.
Hey, wait a minute. You people see anything?
We saw nothing, officer.
What about the kid? Did he see anything?
No.
My son knows nothing.
Maybe he does.
Well, you're wrong. He knows nothing.
What do you mean, Daddy? I know everything. I saw it all.
You know kids, they like to exaggerate.
I don't want him involved in this.
Yeah, come here, kid. You think you can point out the guy who pulled the trigger?
Sure.
Lined up in front of my building were five guys. They were all a part of Sonny's crew. And I knew every single one of them.
Take your hat off.
Eddie Mush.
No, it wasn't him.
Jojo the Whale.
No, not him.
Frankie Coffee Cake.
Not him.
Tony 10 to 2.
No.
What about him?
No, it wasn't him.
Are you satisfied now, officer? Come on, son. Let's go home.
Anybody could be was a rat, and I was not a rat. The day after the killing, my father insisted that I ride the bus with him. I used to love riding the bus with my dad. I'd sit right behind him, and he was in a jazz on a little transistor radio. Everyone loved him. His uniform was always so neat and clean, and his top button was always closed, even if it was 99 degrees outside. My dad never wanted to look sloppy. I was so proud of him. Last stop,
City Island. How you feeling, Calogero?
I'm okay.
You were quiet on the bus?
Just thinking.
About what happened yesterday?
I thought I did a good thing, but now I'm not so sure, Dad.
Did a good thing for a bad man, son. What you did was right, okay?
Thanks, Dad.
All right. Now, who's the greatest ball player that ever lived?
Mickey Mantle.
No way. Joe DiMaggio, the Yankee Clipper. Do you know why he was so great?
Because he was Italian?
Well, that's part of it. But it's because he had talent and he used it.
Do I have talent?
Of course you do.
Just like Joe D.
Yeah, just like Joe D. '56 games in a row. Can't beat that.
That's the record, Pop.
Marion Marilyn Monroe.
Oh, oh, oh!
Tip your head. The best.
Joe D.
He made it look easy. But the Yankee Clipper man, he stood apart.
Why?
Because of his heart.
Because of his heart.
Look to your heart. How do you like the new glove?
I love it, Dad.
Just wait till it's broken in. Hey. Who won the last triple crown?
Mickey Mantle.
Yeah. The Mick. With pain, that could tear a man down.
So?
So what's his trick?
Well, he's strong and he's fast and...
Oh, sure. The man's gifted. His gift's the Olympic. What is that? to your heart. Being a man means you take what you've got and you use it. No, it ain't easy, but use it with honor and pride. When somebody shows you a shortcut, you smile and refuse it. The one road we're taking starts right here inside. Picture the man you can be, then aim true. If you get lost, look to me, I'm here for you. You've got a future, son, I can taste it. You can be anything once you've embraced it. Just use your talent. You understand what I'm saying, son?
I think so.
The saddest thing in life is wasted talent. Promise me you won't waste yours.
I promise, Dad.
My boy has heart. Look to your heart. Let's go get an ice cream.
About what happened on the stoop. I lied, and a man had died. I committed a mortal sin, and I didn't want to burn in hell. So I just thought, hey, I'd go to confession and cleanse my soul. It's great to be a Catholic. You get to start over every week. I got 5 Our Fathers and 5 Hail Marys for a murder rap. My soul was clean, and the Yankees were playing the Pirates in the World Series. It was tied score, bottom of the ninth, when there's a high fly ball going in deep to the left.
No!
This could do it.
No!
Back to the wall goes Barra, and it's over the fence for a home run, and the Pirates win the World Series!
No! Why, God, why? We're 5 Our Fathers and 5 Hail Marys now. Good enough for you?
Kid. Kid. Why are you crying? Crying about? Kid, do you think Mickey Mantle cares about you? Mickey Mantle makes $100,000 a year. How much does your father make? Now, next time your father can't pay rent, go ask Mickey Mantle. See what he says. Forget about this Mickey Mantle stuff, kid, alright? Nobody cares. You hear me? Nobody cares. Now come on. Let's go get an egg cream. Hey, what's your name?
Colosimo.
Sonny took me to the Shea Bippy. That was the neighborhood bar. It was owned by Rudy the Voice. Well, not really. Sonny was the silent partner. And that was the beginning of my education.
Hey! One egg cream for my man Closure over here. Everybody say hello.
Hey.
Everybody say hello.
Hello!
How you doing? Closure!
That's Rudy the Voice. Now, Rudy the Voice was a frustrated singer, but Sonny hated his voice. So just for spite, he'd never utter a spoken word again. He'd only sing it.
Hey, Calandra!
Bring me a cappuccino.
I'll take care of you.
Frankie Coffee Cake. They called him Coffee Cake because his whole face was covered with acne and he looked like a Drake's Coffee Cake.
Hey, Sonny! Somebody threw up in the bathroom!
Eddie Mush. Now, Eddie Mush was a degenerate gambler. He was also the biggest loser in the entire world. He was such a loser, he'd go to the racetrack and the teller would give him his tickets already ripped up. Jojo the Whale. 5'8", 400 pounds. Legend has it his shadow once killed a dog. And finally, there was Sonny's bodyguard, Tony Tendatu. Now they called him Tendatu because his feet always pointed like the clock, 10 to 2. One time, he got shot in the leg. And they called him 20 after. But the best times of all were the crap games. All the big wise guys from all over the neighborhood would come by. Tammy Russo, Paulie C, Billy Baba. All they would stand there acting like who was the toughest, who was the strongest, who had the biggest reputation. And I would watch thousands of dollars change hands back and forth.
Come on! Just one second!
Singer!
Can't get a break! I told you to stop your singing!
Okay!
I can't get enough of my life!
Oh, come on, you don't do this, man!
Hey, Kaloshma, come here! I want you to throw my dice at me, alright?
I've never played dice before, Sonny.
I'll teach you, okay? Come here, stand over here and I'll show you how to do it. Kid's gonna throw my dice!
Oh, come on!
Anybody got a problem with that?
No. No.
Didn't think so. Let me show you how to throw them dice. First, gotta make them treat you nice. Here's a little bit of free advice. So listen to Sonny, we'll make some money. Keep quiet when you shake them bones. Close doors, disconnect the phones. Cause you wanna hear this loser's groans. Let's start the bet. Ready, get set, and roll on. You're my lucky charm.
Roll on.
Use that lucky amazing arm.
Roll on.
Kid, let's bet the farm.
Oh,
tell me how. Making Sonny smile is good.
Hey, Sonny, your kid's gonna look like a wet noodle.
He's not even by the loser.
Everybody shut up. I don't want nobody laughing at this kid. I'm like nobody laughs at my boy.
Ooh.
All right, come on, little troll. You just gotta throw a little heart. I said we put some real money down, all right? I got 3,000 on the kid. Who's betting with me?
I'll go with you, Sonny.
No, no, Eddie Mush, no going. I don't want your money touching my money. I don't want your money in the same neighborhood as my money.
Why?
Because you're a jinx, that's why. You never hit a bet in your entire life. Don't. I feel the win streak coming. Lock Mush in the bathroom for me, will ya?
Come on, Sonny.
Get out of there.
No.
Alright, Felicia, get those dice for me yourself.
Okay, Sonny.
7! Will you look at this kid? Alright, give me those dice. I want to do it again. 5,000! Jojo, can you please back up? Your breath is killing me.
Yeah.
Then go eat in the bathroom. Tony, lock him in there.
Can't fit.
I don't care if he can't fit. Stuff him in there. I want that fat whale away from me. He stinks. Ain't nobody better jinx the kid. Don't you even let me think you did. Say a word, I'm gonna flip my lid. Shut your trap or get in the crapper. Come on, buddy, time to shake that fist. Bob's riding on your magic wrist. Time to fist with a little twist. Pick that cool voice. I don't want watch your face looking at his face while he's trying to throw my dice. Tony, get a towel, put it over Frankie's head.
Come on, Sonny, I want a towel.
Oh, 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 oh! You don't want a towel over your head, huh? It's all right. Fellas, you know what that means.
Into the bathroom!
All right, kid, go ahead.
Seven,
don't get cocky, kid, just throw the dice. Four's a point.
I'm sorry, Sonny.
Four's okay, kid, don't worry about it.
But I didn't throw a seven.
Four's okay, kid. Take it easy. The kid's panicking. He didn't throw a seven. Well, now you just gotta throw another four, right? 2-2 on the hard four. I say we put all the money down, all right?
All right, Sonny, I can throw another seven.
No, no sevens. No sevens.
But I thought Sonny was
not going to. Not now, kid. Kid scared the crap out of me, this kid. No, I need four, okay? 2-2. Let's do it.
Don't throw a seven with this close to heaven. We'll be in the money unless you drop out. Backs got snake eyes, so they'll take guys. The kid is on it. He'll do it, no doubt.
Come on, 2-2.
Fall on like you're born to do.
Roll on, roll on, roll on.
Four! He did it! Madeline! I love this game!
Roll on!
I made 9 passes in a row that day. I don't know how much Sonny won, but when it was over...
I've never seen so much money in my life!
Hey, the worker man's a sucker, kid. Remember that.
Now that bothered me, because my father was a working man, and he was not a sucker.
Hey, can I come back tomorrow and throw your dice again?
Yeah, of course you can come back tomorrow. Close roll.
Close roll.
We gotta do something about that name. No disrespect to your mother and father, but it's a bit long. From now on, I'm gonna call you C.
C?
For Colosimo. And here is a C note for C.
That's $100, Sonny!
Hey, put it in your kick. Don't tell nobody where you got it, alright?
I've never had so much money in my life!
And I've never had a partner in my life. But you know what? I'm gonna go around town, tell everybody that you are with me now. I'll see you tomorrow, C.
So Sonny started taking me everywhere we went. And he introduced me to people as a close friend. And I noticed that strange things started to happen.
Oh,
What's this?
What's what, Daddy?
This. I found this in your room. Where did you get this?
That's money I've been saving, Daddy.
$1,200 you've been saving. Did you become a brain surgeon overnight, son?
No, Dad. I worked for it.
Doing what? Things.
What things?
Few things here, few things there.
What things did you do?
I worked the craft games.
What?
Sonny gave me a job.
Sonny? I knew it.
Wonder why the neighborhood drinks pulling kings of awful good. Playing craps is shining up his car. We're going straight to the bar to give back the money.
What?
Aren't you about to get your mom upset?
But
that's right, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Daddy, Daddy, don't say nothing, please. I made a promise to Sonny.
Let's go.
Now.
But wait! Let's not make any rash decisions.
What?
Money like that you don't pull from a hat. I mean, $1,200 can buy us a lot.
It's blood money.
I know, and it's wrong even so. I mean, who's gonna know if we spend it or why?
It's dirty, the
Daddy, Daddy, don't say that to my
advice. Lorenzo, please.
Let's go, now. Involved in your scams.
Excuse me, Lorenzo, but what scams are you talking about?
Please, I'm not a stupid man. I'm warning you to stay away from my son.
What did you just say to me? Tony, sit down. Hey, Lorenzo, you and I should talk. See, I'd like it if you take a walk.
Hey, I'm a spy better and now the side. Lodro, wait outside.
First of all, show me disrespect. Number two, I teach that boy correct. Do the right thing, go to college.
Please, Sonny, you don't need your kind of knowledge. The clothes, the cars, the money, the girls, all that bad, well, what's it meant? Now you're saying that Mickey Mantle wouldn't pay my rent?
Can you believe this, kid?
I mean, it's not funny. It's not funny when your 9-year-old son has a bigger bank account than you do.
Now that's not my problem, Lorenzo. As I'm sure you remember, I offered you a job. All you had to do was take my numbers from one bus stop to the next. No one would have suspected you because of who you are. And it would have meant another $150 in your cake every week. But hey, you said no to me.
That's right, I did. And I'd say no to you again. You couldn't corrupt me, so now you want to corrupt him!
What the hell's the matter with you? I treat that boy like he's my own son!
He's not your son!
Get him out of here! I wash my hands!
Stay away from
him! Get him out of here!
Stay away
from him! Out.
Where's my money, Dad? What did Sonny say? Pay my money?
I left it in there.
What? How could you do that? I worked for it as my money!
Stay away from him!
I want my money!
No!
Daddy, I want it!
Shut up!
I want my money! Give me my money!
Shut up.
Why did you hit me? Why? Sonny's right. He's right. The working man is a sucker. He's a sucker.
Sonny's wrong. It doesn't take much strength to pull the trigger, Claude Giroux. Let's see him get up every morning and work for a living. Then we'll see who the real tough guy is. Your father is the tough guy. That man is evil.
How can he be evil? People love him. Just like they love you on the bus. They love you. They love him. It's the same thing.
It's not the same. People don't love him, they fear him. There's a difference.
I don't understand, Dad.
You won't when you get older. I'm sorry I hit you. You know that I love you. Just stay away from him, okay?
Okay.
I guess I should have listened, but I was just a kid. I thought that I knew better. And hell, perhaps I did. From out of the bar, I heard voices I knew. and music and laughter, and Sonny's voice too. And I felt bad.
But I liked it.
Ignored my dad.
'Cause I liked it.
And if he didn't know, heck, what's an hour or so? And somehow 1 hour turned into 2, and somehow 2 hours just kept on going. Hours became days.
Weeks went by in a haze.
Too late. Years passed before without any sign of slowing.
Da 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 da.
And Sonny's dream kept growing. Guess what he became? The cupboard and tootsie copy, the East Coast's biggest name. And wise guys have come from all over the land to pay their respects, kiss his ring, shake his hand. L.A.
Hey, Louie, how you doing?
Miami.
Hi, Louie, how you doing?
Chicago.
I'm doing good, how you doing?
Detroit.
Kidding.
Las Vegas.
I call him C, and I like him, the kid's with me, 'cause I like him. If you smart fellas, you'd better like the kid too.
We like him!
And suddenly I found myself in 1968, the Yankees in the cellar, the Beatles sounding great, the bars always jumping, the laughs never end. And I'm Sonny's guy, I'm his boy, I'm his friend, and I liked it. Yeah, I liked it. Oh yeah, Sonny's reign had begun, and I was like Sonny's son, and I liked it.
I liked it, I liked it,
yeah, I liked it.
I liked it.
And when I wasn't with Sonny, I had my own crew. I mean, I'd hang with these guys day in and day out, and I loved these guys. I loved every single one of them. There was Sally Slick. We called him that because his hair was always slicked back. And Handsome Nick. He was so pretty he wanted to sleep with himself. And finally, Crazy Mario kept hearing voices in his head.
Who's that? Nobody!
All we wanted was to be like Sonny and his crew. We were trying to walk like them, talk like them, even dress like them, right?
She can't be trusted!
You're a sick person, Mario.
Hating the truth.
You're a fool and everyone makes sense.
Hating the truth.
Ignore me at your own expense. She takes the acting frisky, getting married's pretty risky.
And that's the truth. Ba-do-wop, ba-ba-ba-da-da-da. Ba-do-wop, sha-sha-shu-ba-da-ba.
Hey, what are you still walking over here?
Yeah, this is our neighborhood. Hey, come on, guys, cool it. They're not bothering anybody. Forget about it.
My father told me that's how it starts. He said you'll run in and take over the neighborhood.
Hey, come on, Slick.
You wanna know what it takes to be a real partisan? You stand on the side of what's right. And when those guys get ideas that it's your blood they're on, you quit acting all polite.
Hey, Slick, listen!
You get up in their faces and you show them where their place is.
You got baseball bat fans.
No doubt.
Cause you let one or two in and the whole place goes to ruin.
And who else will keep the jerks out?
Ain't it the truth?
You know it, every single word.
Ain't it the truth?
Exactly like we always heard. The next tribe that passes you, your man will kick their asses. And that's
the truth. Follow you up, 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 up,
up, up, up, up, felt the same way, except me. In this neighborhood, it was always about the streets and who owned them. We couldn't set foot on Webster Avenue, and they couldn't come anywhere near Belmont. School was right in the middle of the two, but even then we stayed apart. Well, at least my friends did. But me? I was having a hard time keeping my distance.
Hi. I saw you standing here. Are you waiting for somebody?
Yes, I am.
Oh, you are? I'm sorry.
I'm just waiting for my brother. He's late.
Really? That's great!
That he's late?
No, that he's your brother. My name's Calogero.
Calogero. What kind of name is that?
It's Sicilian. My family's from Sicily.
I'm Jane. My family's from two blocks down and make a left.
Jane. I like that. Hey, listen, you ever go out?
Like on a date?
Yeah.
With you?
Yeah.
No.
Why not?
Why do you think?
Oh, come on, it's just a date. Who knows? You might get to like me.
You're funny.
So is that a yes?
People will see us.
What about a movie? It'll be dark.
I don't think that's a good idea.
Where are you going?
Why do you want to know?
In case I need to find you.
I'm going to work.
You got a job?
I'm saving up for college, aren't you?
College? What, are you kidding?
Well, why not? My girlfriend Denise is in your English class, and she says you're smarter than you look.
Oh. So you talk about me.
She says you can really write.
Yeah, well, my friends would laugh their asses off if I told them I was going to college.
Well, then maybe you need new friends.
You know what? Maybe.
Cousin's record store.
What?
That's where I work.
On Fordham Road?
Yeah, and I can't be late.
But what about your brother?
Just tell him I couldn't wait.
I don't know what he looks like.
He's black.
I must be out of my head, but I've got it as bad as can be. God help me, she's so fine, but it's crossing a line. Girls like her don't happen. Girls like her can't happen. Girls like Jane don't happen. Two guys like...
What are you doing?
Hey, Dad, I got a question for you. So you know Joey Llama from up the block?
Yeah.
Well, Joey's dating this black girl, and the guys are giving him a lot of crap about it. I mean, what do you think about that?
You know how I feel about that. I get along with everybody on the bus. There's good and bad in every kind.
You really mean that, Dad?
Yeah.
Well, what would you do if I ever dated a black girl, Dad? What would you do then?
You would never do that.
Yeah, well, sometimes you gotta just do what your heart tells you to, you know?
Who told you that?
Joey Llama.
Well, you tell Joey Llama that sometimes in the heat of passion, the little head tells the bigger head what to do. And the bigger head should think twice. I'll see you upstairs.
What? Louis! Louis Beans! Where's the $20 you owe me? Hey! Hey! Get back here, you little rat! You can't run forever!
What the hell are you talking about?
Louis Beans, Sonny. He owes me $20. It's been 2 weeks now. I mean, he's making me look bad in front of the other guys. Like, should I whack this
guy? Whoa! Take it easy. First off, this Louis Beans, is he a good friend of yours?
No. He's a complete butt of guts. But he owes me $20.
Forget the 20.
What? Why?
He's never gonna bother you again? He's never gonna ask you for money again. He's out of your life for $20. You got off cheap, kid. Forget about it.
You're right, Sonny.
What have I been telling you? You're going to the best school in the entire world, the University of Belmont Avenue. But you gotta get two educations, one from the streets and one from school. That way, you're twice as smart as everybody else. Read a book once in a while, why don't you?
Read a book? Yeah, like you read.
Of course I read. They sent me away to college a few times, you know what I'm saying? I used to read philosophy. You ever hear this guy Machiavelli?
Who?
Niccolo Machiavelli. Let me tell you something about this guy, Nick Machiavelli. If he was around today, he would be my concierge. Nicky Machiavelli. Let me tell you what he said. You wanna use the reins of power? First, you gotta use your head. Nicky knew all the angles. Nicky laid it out real clear. You gotta choose fear or love, kid. You gotta choose love or fear.
Love or fear?
That's right, see. Nicky's number one secret.
was availability. That's why I'm here on this corner, right where all the world can see. All my friends, they sleep easy, knowing that I'm always near. My enemies know it too, though it ain't about love, it's fear. And as far as those friends go, niggas are just a real short leash. Treat them well, but not too well. Keep them in your net, gabish. Give them too much, they won't need ya. Give too little and they'll sneer. You wanna know what to give up? The answer ain't love, it's fear. Frankie, Tony, and Jojo, look at how it is with them. Sure you think these fellas love me? Think again, says Nicky M. I'm making jokes. A lot like weeks, even when you spread it thick. Money can't buy your friendship, love can always disappear. Fear is cash in the bank, kid. Fear puts gas in your tank, kid. And now you got Nicky to thank, kid.
I walked in, was a big deal. On this particular day, a biker gang came in, and they had a reputation.
Excuse me, I can't come in. We're closed.
I just want a drink.
Is there a problem here?
No problem, we just want a few beers. Maybe you can help us out, sir.
Spoken like a true gentleman. I appreciate that. Rudy, give him the beers.
Thanks for the beers.
Now that was very nice. Now you and your friends gotta leave.
We gotta leave? Can you hear that, fellas? Brando says we gotta leave. This is our place, not whose fault. We ain't leaving.
Now, you can't leave. About yourself.
with us. You hear me? This is our neighborhood. Now get out of here!
When did it happen? How did I lose you? Why did I stand there and let that man use you? I won't watch it happen. Son, I refuse to. I was there on the morning you first saw the light. Every night, taught you how to play ball and watched you grow tall. I've still got it all inside, and no matter the cost, I won't let that be lost. Son, these streets won't take you away from me. No, these streets won't break up this family. Not to these streets. Didn't I tell you bad things happen hanging around, Sonny? Come upstairs.
No.
What did you say?
What was I supposed to do, Dad? Just run away? Make them think I got no heart?
No heart? On these streets you mean nothing. Trust me, they don't care.
You don't even know Sonny.
I know how he thinks. Messed up once, watch what happens. They'll leave you bleeding somewhere.
Well, you're wrong. Sonny, trust me.
There's no honor, no trust. Do what they must. They kill if it's justified. They'll make you a pawn in their war.
Come on, Dad.
You meant for much more.
Yeah? But what was I meant for?
I don't want you to have to look over your shoulder all the time or owe anybody anything. I want you to have a better life than that.
Like yours? We have no car, no money. We have nothing.
You've gotta look to your heart.
What am I supposed to be, a bus driver like you?
Don't you get trapped here, be smart!
Sonny's right!
Cologero.
The working man is a sucker!
Cologero.
He's a sucker!
Life be mislaid, you promised me.